Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography brought to you by Adorama. It's the camera store that has everything for photographers like you and me. Well, in this episode, I want to talk to you about why I think the GoPro Hero 5 is the best GoPro ever made and some things that you need to know about when you start using your Hero 5 or if you're considering buying one. Also, I want to talk about this guy right here. This is the Karma Grip that I absolutely love. But again, there's some things that you need to know about when you're using this guy, specifically the audio, how you can hold it, and what it's not meant to be used for. And so we're gonna get into that. But first, let's talk about the audio quality of the GoPro Hero 5. We're gonna get to that right now. This has some pretty interesting features. Now, built in, there are two different types of microphones. There's one that's built for lots of wind, so if you're in a moving vehicle or running down a ski slope or something like that. And then stereo, and the GoPro will automatically switch between those two things based on what it thinks is best. Or you can override that and tell the GoPro Hero 5 to only use stereo or only use wind, which is awesome. But you can also use an external microphone, a wireless microphone or a lavalier. There's a bunch of different options. The way that works is with this guy right here. This is the external audio interface and also allows you to plug in an external battery. It's got USB-C that lets you plug that in. So that's pretty cool, except you can see that this thing is pretty huge. I mean, it's almost as big as the GoPro itself. So there've been a lot of complaints about the size of this thing. So if you're doing a vlog or something, to try to figure out how that mounts is something that, I don't know, it's not one of my favorite things about this camera. Well, let me talk to you about how this works. On the side of the waterproof case, this case doesn't need any kind of enclosure, it's totally waterproof, there's this little door. And you open that door and you can take this off. Now once you do that, then your USB ports are exposed right there and this then can plug in. Now you've got this big dongle that's plugged into your USB port and then you can plug in an external microphone. So I'm using a door lavalier mic. There's a bunch of different lavaliers or external mics that will work. You can use a non-powered, a powered. There are a bunch of different options for this, and so that's really nice. So once you have this, now you have the ability to get the camera away from the audio component. Your audio is going to be much, much better. I think that's pretty cool. The other thing that's pretty cool about this is it allows you to put it in the case, and there's a little cutout here, and so you still have access to plug in this through the case. So if you're in a car or something, that works really nice. One of the things that I think is a failure that GoPro hasn't addressed yet is if you want to use an external microphone with the Karma Grip, you can't. So, and I'm not sure why, but on the bottom here, you have your USB port that you can charge and do all kinds of things. But when you plug in an external microphone, well, guess what? It doesn't do anything. It doesn't work at all. I talked to GoPro about this and they said, nope, it doesn't work. And so maybe that's coming with a firmware update, I don't know. But for now, Karma Grip, no external audio. That is a negative in my book. Now I have the external microphone hooked up to this camera and you can hear that it is much clearer than the built-in microphone. And the nice thing about this is if I want to stop and maybe put it on a table or something, I can go quite a distance from my GoPro Hero 5 using this long cable. And it is going to absolutely sound perfect. Now, if I was gonna do this in real life, I'd probably have an external wireless microphone, so you wouldn't have a cable. But you can see how this would work great on a motorcycle or maybe on a different kind of a vehicle or in a shop, or if you're doing a vlog, woodworking, that kind of stuff, you can have an external microphone that works just fine. And so it's well worth the money to spend. It's about $100 to get a nice lavalier microphone and get awesome audio quality. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna check the image stabilization and audio. This is something that might be useful if you're a vlogger, you wanna record yourself. So this again, field of view wide, image stabilization turned on. This has image stabilization turned on with the gimbal. This is set to auto, so it's gonna switch between wind and stereo, but this camera, I've set it to stereo only because I know that that's what I want. So GoPro, start recording. We'll start this guy. Now we're just gonna walk and talk. So hey everybody, here I am in beautiful Frankfurt, Germany on one of the most amazing streets ever because they've got coffee, they've got schnitzel, they've got all kinds of really amazing things. And let's see what that sounds like with just the audio here. So here's my stereo audio. This is this camera right here, stereo only. And then this is this camera right here with the gimbal with auto
audio gain.
And so we'll see how that sounds. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna compare the image stabilization on a GoPro with the image stabilization on a GoPro Karma Grip. So both of these are set to a wide field of view, 1080p, 30 frames per second. And so we're gonna start right now. So GoPro, start recording. I'll start this guy. Now we're just gonna walk down this street and you can see side by side what it looks like with image stabilization and image stabilization with a Karma Grip. When you get your Karma Grip, you need to be able to hold it correctly. You're thinking maybe like this, but this is not the correct way to hold the Karma Grip. You need to hold it either horizontally, like this, or at a 45 degree angle, like this, and that'll give you the full range of motion. So either this or this, but never this. And if you do this, you're gonna get the best results. Now with the Hero 5, the time-lapse ability is built in. Not only is it gonna shoot a bunch of stills, but you don't have to put them into After Effects or Premiere or something to make your time-lapse video. It comes out ready to go, and it couldn't be easier with the touchscreen. So let me show you how this works. So I go to my mode button and say I'm in my time-lapse video, and then down on the bottom, I've got all my options. And so I wanna set this to a 1 second interval instead of 5 seconds. I can choose my field of view. Linear looks pretty good. Once I have that, I can choose different options. I'm just gonna go with the normal time-lapse video. That's all there is to it. I am ready to go. And so I'm gonna shoot a time-lapse video on our way to our next segment. And so follow me. Well, in addition to holding your Karma Grip correctly, like this or like this, one other thing I discovered is that it is not meant to be a vehicle mount. And I learned that by accident. So I sort of mounted this to my motorcycle's pannier. I just sort of stuck it on like this. And I took a little trip through Barcelona. What I found was as I was zipping around the corners, my GoPro started to tilt more and more and more until it was almost at a 90 degree angle. I thought, what is going on here? So I looked on GoPro's website, and sure enough, it says clearly, this is not meant to be a vehicle mount. And so if you're looking for a vehicle mount, you can do that with a GoPro, just not with the Karma Grip. Things I've learned about the Karma Grip is sometimes the GoPro can be a little bit off level, and the way to solve that is to calibrate the Karma Grip. It's really, really simple. So you have to make sure that the whole thing is turned off. So I'll turn off my Karma Grip. There it is, it's turned off. And then all you need to do is find a flat level surface like a table or something like this. and make sure that you put this with the buttons up, and then you just press and hold the tilt control for 8 seconds. And once I count out to 8 seconds, what's gonna happen is this is gonna start going through a bunch of gyrations, and it will calibrate itself so that it is totally level. So if you see that your GoPro is a little bit off on your camera grip, just do this calibration and things are going to be fantastic. I'm gonna let this go. It'll take a little while. It'll do this a couple times. Once it finally shuts off, the buttons or the little lights are gonna stop flashing, then I know it's all good and ready to go. There you have it, the GoPro Hero 5 and Karma Grip. It's a match made in heaven. I hope you learned a few things that will help you get the most out of your GoPro Hero 5. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV. It's absolutely free. And also check out the Adorama Learning Center, where you can see articles about the Hero 5 and editing and all those things. Plus, you can see articles written by me. I'm now writing articles at the Adorama Learning Center twice a month. Don't miss it. It's absolutely free. Thanks again for joining us, and I will see you again next time.